Hi, I'm Vasuja Kal, and thank you so much for joining us today. First and foremost, I hope you all are staying safe and taking care of yourselves and of each other in these very challenging times. As the security landscape continues to evolve, organizations face a variety of risks that extend well beyond traditional cybersecurity. That's why we believe in a comprehensive approach to security and data management, and we view data protection, governance, and compliance as integral parts of an effective data strategy. At Microsoft, we embrace a zero-trust approach to security and compliance. This is not only the practice of protecting against threats from coming from outside the organization, but also from those that can originate inside. For us, compliance and managing risks related to data are pivotal to inside-out protection. And that doesn't just mean safeguarding data stored in the Microsoft cloud. It means empowering organizations to govern and protect data across all clouds and all platforms. After all, according to a recent Flexera report, 92% of organizations have embraced a multi-cloud strategy. To help organizations meet today's global compliance requirements across their multi-cloud, multi-platform data environment, we are so excited to announce Microsoft Purview. Microsoft Purview is a portfolio of solutions for information protection, data governance, risk management, and compliance that enables organizations to effectively manage their data. It provides enhanced visibility that organizations can leverage across their environment to help close gaps that can lead to data exposure, simplify tasks through automation, stay up to date with regulatory requirements, and keep their most important asset, their data, secure. Microsoft Purview brings together unified data governance from data and AI and risk and compliance solutions from security. They work with identity and access management, threat protection, cloud security, endpoint management, and privacy management for comprehensive protection against both external and internal threats. So why is this so important today? For most organizations, data has become the lifeblood of every business. But with the shift to hybrid work and the unprecedented levels of digital transformation, an organization's data often lives outside of the traditional borders of business. Not only is this data stored and accessed across a range of on-premise, multi-cloud, and SaaS applications, but it is also subject to rapidly evolving global regulations. According to Microsoft research, over 30% of compliance and risk decision makers report feeling challenged to know what sensitive or business-critical data they possess, let alone where it's located. This can make it nearly impossible for organizations to protect their data, close gaps that can lead to exposure, comply with regulatory requirements, or even manage access controls. For data to fuel digital transformation, it must be readily discoverable, understandable, and high quality. Its collection, processing, and use must also adhere to regulations and industry standards. An IBM study estimated that by 2020, up to 93% of an organization's data is not able to be located or used effectively. In fact, organizations are even faced with solving an immediate need to reduce their data surface area by deleting the data they don't need and retaining the data they do need in order to more effectively protect against leaks and breaches. So here with me today is Aleem Royani, General Manager for Compliance and Privacy Marketing, to tell us more about how Microsoft is helping to solve for these challenges.
Thanks, Vasu. I'm excited to talk to you today about Microsoft Purview. Microsoft Purview joins together Azure Purview and our suite of Microsoft 365 compliance solutions. Previously, customers used Azure Purview for unified data governance and Microsoft 365 compliance solutions to protect their data and manage risks across their organization. We believe these are inherently connected and must be treated in a comprehensive way. Now more than ever, it's become critical to optimize your strategy to deliver a unified view of data across your hybrid, multi-cloud environments by bringing together vectors of risk, productivity, compliance, and security. Historically, the marketers responded with dozens of products that address fragments of the data governance and compliance landscape. This forces chief data, chief security, chief compliance, and chief legal officers to stitch together a patchwork of solutions that don't always work. This exposes infrastructure gaps that are costly and complex to manage. In fact, a recent survey of compliance and risk decision makers by MDC Research showed that to meet their compliance and data protection needs, almost 80% had purchased multiple products, and a majority had purchased three or more. It's not just more work, it's also ineffective. Security outcomes can worsen, audits can fail, brand reputation can be damaged. That's why we're extending the Purview name and rebranding the data governance and compliance portfolios to Microsoft Purview. In bringing these pieces together under one brand, Microsoft Purview can help you understand and govern the data across your estate, safeguard that data wherever it lives, and improve your risk and compliance posture. Along with this extension of the Microsoft Purview brand, we're announcing several new, exciting product updates across our portfolio. We're committed to investing in extending our capabilities across clouds and platforms. Our latest update to support multi-cloud and multi-platform is the general availability of endpoint data loss prevention for macOS, helping customers to prevent sensitive data exfiltration on Mac devices. And with this shift to multi-cloud environments, it's important for customers to feel confident that their business-critical data is secure and protected. But before sensitive data can be safely shared, it first needs to be identified. To that end, we're extending our sensitive information type catalog with more than 50 new classifiers. The new classifiers are available across our portfolio of solutions, and they even support our new privacy solution, Microsoft Priva. This greatly improves the accuracy and comprehensiveness of policy templates such as GDPR and HIPAA, so organizations can better identify and protect sensitive data in accordance with global regulatory standards and privacy laws. Today, we're announcing the general availability of named entities detection, an advanced classification technique that leverages over 50 new sensitive information types, which support person names, physical addresses, and medical terms and conditions. Now let's talk about data governance. With any file's lifecycle, organizations need to be able to configure retention and deletion settings to make sure that file stays compliant with regulations. To simplify that process, we're announcing the public preview of multi-stage retention, which automatically applies a new label when an item reaches the end of its retention period. Now organizations don't need to compromise between modern collaboration and compliance. Our insider risk management capabilities help customers identify and take action on insider threats. To enhance insider risk management, users will get more actionable insights into their environment with policy recommendations and sequencing support within analytics. In addition, there'll be deeper integration for insider risk with Microsoft Defender for cloud apps. Lots of exciting news from across the team. So, how can you get started? Check out our free trial or webpage to learn more. We're working on integrating what customers know today as the Azure Purview data platform across these solutions. You'll see these updates in the future on the unified platform, shared policy engine, and much more. Today, we have our Corporate Vice President of Compliance and Privacy Product Management who's speaking with one of our customers about how they've been on this data governance journey since the beginning. Over to you, Rudy.
All right, that's amazing, Aline. Thank you. Now I'm here with Igor Zyganski, President and CTO of Bridgewater Associates. And he's going to talk to us about some of the pillars mentioned by Aleem. Bridgewater Associates, of course, manages assets and clientele on a global scale. The firm governs data for themselves and for their clients. And so Igor, can you introduce yourself and share your journey in data governance and data security?
My name is Igor Zyganski. I run technology here at Bridgewater. I am responsible for pretty much anything that is digital at Bridgewater, infrastructure-wise or investment system-wise, I am responsible for.
Great. Thanks for taking the time, Igor. So what are some of the biggest challenges that you see as president and CTO around data governance?
In the simplest way, it's knowing where our information is, right? At any given point in time. What information, and what data is being handled by whom and where.
Now, if you wouldn't mind, can you tell me a little bit about Bridgewater's journey thus far? Data governance and data security, of course, isn't something just that happens overnight. A lot of planning, a lot of execution, a lot of thought leadership. How do you navigate some of these corporate requirements?
It's a great question. A couple of years ago, we have decided to partner with Microsoft, share all of our requirements with Microsoft in a way that benefits us as well as the community, as well as everyone else who may be using the products from Microsoft. And we're at the point where most of our needs are met by a suite of products and services that Microsoft provides that allows us to basically manage information governance, make sure that our insiders are acting in a way that we think that they should be acting in our internal agreement of how we want to be with each other, as well as our partners, right? And that we're responsible in the way we communicate to our customers and act responsibly on behalf of our customers. And that, you know, the suite of those products, I'm so glad that you've decided to take a suite of those, all the different functionalities that you've created, and put it all together into one suite of products that we're talking about today. So the journey in many ways has been very rewarding because we can see always on where our information is, who is accessing it, who maybe have been taking it out from the area. So not just who has the information, how they're using it, but where geographically the information is dispersed.
Yeah, thanks, Igor. And just to kind of reciprocate, it's been an awesome, awesome partnership. And you've pushed the products hard and the products have gotten better. And I'm truly thankful for the relationship we have across the companies here. I'm assuming, as you talked about the suite of products and as you talked about the multiple, you know, sort of groups that work with these products, it requires, of course, collaboration. It requires workflows. Is that a good assumption? And how do you handle that?
Yeah, that's a great assumption. Well, the way we handle it is internally, we have a set of product managers that work with business owners, determining what the needs of the business owners are. And then we both continuously adjust the configuration of the product to the needs of our business, enable our businesses to collaborate, because for us, all the different businesses, let's say we may be talking about security versus legal and compliance versus some other business, at the end of the day, all the things need to converge, right? So, you know, you might be writing an email and we want to make sure that when you're writing an email, you're doing it in a certain format that is appropriate for the relationship. But at the same time, it needs to be done. Let's say you're only allowed to write a certain amount of email from work, right? And not allowed to write a certain amount of email from home. And by amount, that's probably the wrong word. I mean, the certain type of an email, right? From work, and then you're not allowed to work on certain types of things from home if the topic that is maybe very, very sensitive. Well, at Bridgewater, different departments handle those two different things, but it all rotates around one same object called email. And so from one standpoint of view, understanding the needs of different departments is very important, but then converging that into the same set of requirements for the same product is extremely important.
Yeah, this idea that you talked about, which is that, you know, success with managing data, managing threats and risks, it really is a team sport and requires, you know, more than one person, an entire team of folks to be working through. It's such an important idea. That's great. Igor, you know, it's been an awesome ride journey together over the last few years. Any final thoughts and insights on data governance and data security?
Yeah, well, first of all, keep going. I think that you're building a great product, and again, I'm thankful for the work that you've done. Second is, for many organizations, I would strongly suggest for folks to consider not just features and functionalities, but the cross-integrated nature of how these features and functionalities need to come together. We haven't been able to find anything close to what Microsoft has from the breadth of integrations and coverage across the board, and the set of partnerships that you folks have with other firms. So my advice, Consider the full scope. Don't focus on features and functionalities. Consider the full requirement set across the board.
Yeah, that's great, Igor. Thank you. And then to summarize, it's this idea that you talked about that success with managing threats and governance isn't just the responsibility of one person or one team. It's a holistic approach across an organization that needs to be taken, right?
Yeah, absolutely. It takes a village. It's the whole organization. Different companies have different setups, you know, but at the end of the day, this is where the core business comes in. Furthermore, the benefit of the Microsoft solution is it tightly integrates with the cybersecurity risks as well, and not only focuses on all the stuff, data governance, all the stuff that we're talking about, but builds into a bigger cybersecurity solution. And although this is not a point of this conversation, but the notion that those things are so cross-integrated with each other and that cybersecurity flows into data governance and vice versa, that data governance flows into cybersecurity is extremely important, extremely important. Then taking all of that and then integrating that into Azure, into an operating system, into a productivity suite of products and all of its services and SQL Server in the future and others, then becomes basically a no-brainer and an amazing thing.
That's great, Igor. Thank you so much for taking the time to share your thoughts and insights. This has been an incredibly valuable conversation. And with that, back to you, Vasu.
What great insights from Bridgewater. Thank you, Igor, for spending time with us today. And to you, our Microsoft community, thank you for joining us today. Make sure to visit aka.ms/Microsoft Purview to learn more about our data governance and risk management portfolio. Thank you.